Welcome to Simply Learn, Hadoop versus Spark. My name is Richard Kirshner with the Simply Learn team. That is www.simplylearn.com. Get certified, get ahead. The important topics you want to know between Hadoop and Spark is a comparison based on the below criteria. We want to look at performance, cost, fault tolerance, data processing, ease of use, language support, scalability, security, machine learning, and scheduler. Now, it's important to note that a lot of systems will run both Hadoop and Spark. And there's reasons to run just Hadoop, and there's reasons to run just Spark. And so looking at these different points helps pick what is going to work best for your company or your project and what you're doing. So we look at performance. Hadoop is generally slow, as it performs operations on the disk and cannot deliver near real-time analytics from the data. So there's no real-time analytics going on here. You can't have somebody on their web page pulling something up, they push a button, and the real-time analytics comes back in from the Hadoop. Where Spark runs 100 times faster in memory and 10 times faster on disk. And that's important to understand that when we have memory, you're dealing with loading everything into RAM versus reading and writing from the disk. If Spark runs on YARN with other resources demanding services, there could be a major degradation. So it's faster in-memory processing. And that YARN setup is important to know because Hadoop uses YARN also. So if they're both running in the same YARN setup, you could end up like with the degradation going on there. Cost. Hadoop is less expensive as it is an open source software. It requires more memory on disk, which is relatively to an inexpensive commodity. The best description I had of Hadoop is you have two enterprise computers, which are sitting on top of the stack, and those are the ones, usually the master one and controlling everything, and everything else is just a cheap knockoff. That was the best deal thing I could come up with. So you can use really lowered commodity type computers that are very inexpensive, and you can scale up linearly with those commodity computers for memory and for use of disk space. Spark, on the other hand, is also open source, but requires a lot of RAM to run in memory. This increases the cluster size and its cost. That RAM setup can be one of the biggest expenses you have on your different servers that you put in as you start loading up a rack of computers with this. Fault tolerance. Hadoop is highly fault tolerant because it was designed to replicate data across many nodes. Each file is split into blocks and replicated numerous times across many machines. But in special cases, you might have four different replications of it at any one time. Apache Spark uses resilient distributed datasets, RDDS, which are fault-tolerant collections of elements that can be operated on in parallel. Now, both run parallel operations, but with Spark, it's all running in the RAM, and it's very fast. That's what makes it so quick, is it's trying to put everything it can to run in RAM. Hadoop processes data in batches. MapReduce operates in sequential steps by reading data from the cluster, performing its operations on the data, writing the results back to the cluster. And so you can think of this as you queue up your process that you're going to do on there. It might be something that runs at night, checks what's going on as far as like log files. Maybe it is a one-time project running something that's going to go in there and itemize all the data and run some basic analytics for the bank or something like that. Apache Spark. Spark performs batch, real-time, and graph processing of data. It reads data from the cluster, performs its operation on the data, and then writes it back to the cluster. So here we have that you can still do batch processing, which is what Hadoop is very centered on, is you batch things up and you walk away and come back and get your answer. In addition to that, though, Spark can handle the real-time processing and the graph processing in data. Ease of use. Hadoop's MapReduce has no interactive mode and is complex. It needs to handle low-level APIs to process the data, which require lots of coding. So when I'm writing a code for Hadoop, and when I'm going to run, like, say, a general query with some basic analytics in it, I could have 120 lines of code in there. Very easily, I can get it way up there as far as my JavaScript or whatever I'm writing it in. Spark supports user-friendly APIs for different languages. It has an interactive mode and provides intermediate feedbacks for queries and actions. To give you an idea, 120 lines of code in Hadoop and Java in their MapReduce can be written in almost one line in Spark. This makes Spark very powerful and ease of use as far as a package on there for processing your data analytics. Language support. Hadoop framework is developed in Java programming language, while MapReduce applications can be written in Python, R, and C++. So when I was talking about the Java side of it, normally most code for Hadoop is written in Java, but it does have packages, and you can go ahead and do your development in both Python, R, and C++. MapReduce supports programming languages. One of the reasons to use a Python module instead of the resident module of Java is that you might use a Hadoop to pull the data and then be processing it in something else like Spark, which is actually very common. It's a very common thing to do, to use the Hadoop as a file system behind the processing of a Spark processor. Apache Spark is developed in Scala language and supports other programming languages like Python, R, and Java. If you never use Scala, it's very similar to Python, and very similar to Python in there, and if you've done C++, they're very similar languages and easy to go between the two. Because Python has such a high integration with the Spark, Python is one of the preferred languages along with Scala for using Spark. Scalability. When we talk about scalability, Hadoop is highly scalable, as we can add n number of nodes in the cluster. Yahoo reportedly used 42,000 node Hadoop cluster. That's 42,000 servers all connected together. Each time they add a new computer in, you're just paying for that computer. This isn't like an enterprise machine where it goes up exponentially to get the higher processing. So this is one of the big things about Hadoop, is it's very scalable and very affordable. The largest known Spark cluster has 8,000 nodes, but as big data grows, it's expected that cluster sizes will increase to maintain throughput expectations. So Spark also is very highly scalable. Again, you're adding just one computer in at a time. Security. Hadoop supports Kerberos and LDAP for authentication. It also supports Access Control List, ACLs, and traditional file permissions model. Spark's security is a bit sparse, as it supports authentication via passwords. If you run Spark on an HDFS, that's your Hadoop file system, it can use the HDFS ACLs and file level permissions. Additionally, Spark can run on Yarn, giving it the capability of using Kerberos and authentication. One of the things to realize when we're looking at security in the whole package, Hadoop came first. And Hadoop was, hey, how do we take a bunch of cheap computers, link them together, and store a massive amount of data and still be able to go query it and do some basic processing on it. And that was great until our processing becomes more and more complicated. When you're doing a neural network, data analytics, linear regression model, suddenly that process takes a long time because of the way Hadoop functions. So Spark came along and said, hey, we can increase that process by running it in the RAM. We can do a lot more. So if you have a huge amount of data, you might store it in the Hadoop file system with running the Spark on top of it to do the processing. If you have just a few gigabytes of data, you know, a small amount of data, under 10 terabytes, you might have that stored on a couple enterprise computers and have the Spark set up with multiple servers on there that is then running all of that in the RAM. Machine learning. Hadoop uses Mihaut and processing data and building models. Also, Samsara and Scala-backed DSL language can be used for in-memory algebraic operations and allows users to write their own algorithms. Spark has built-in machine learning library that can be used for classification and regression. It can also build machine learning pipelines with hyperparameter tuning. This is a huge jump. Having run between these two, not many people use the Mihaut anymore. They might still use it for some older processing, but because it's still using the Hadoop processing MapReduce, it's reading and writing things to the hard drive multiple times, where Spark is only doing that once. So the jump in speed between the Spark and the Mihaut, the Spark machine learning library, is huge. When you start getting into doing more machine library processing other than a few simple things, usually you want to go ahead and jump into the Spark processing setup. Scheduler. Hadoop MapReduce is dependent on an external scheduler. So you might have Zookeeper or something like that tracking what's going in. And remember, it's a batch process. So when we schedule it, you schedule the process, you get a flag when it's done. Apache Spark has its own scheduler, so it's a little bit more integrated for tracking what's going on. And since you have more real time, it's important that it has its own scheduler because it's integrated with the Spark system. So we took a quick glance at Spark and Hadoop. I want to thank you for joining us today for that. You can really sum this up by thinking of Hadoop as the Hadoop file system for storing large amounts of data, and the Spark for processing large amounts of data, and they can be integrated quite nicely with each other. For more information, visit us at www.simplylearn.com. Get certified, get ahead.
Hi there, if you like this video, subscribe to the Simply Learn YouTube channel and click here to watch similar videos. To nerd up and get certified, click here.